the beginning of Van Halen. We're tracking down Eddie tonight. Good stuff. This guy's stopping for.
Thought you needed a taxi.
Eddie will be on this video. I'm gonna track him down. They're not. They're fucking here. Selling them.
I know.
No. That's a bet. We're just making a friendly bet.
A member of the event staff and located that information on the inside counter. What is that?
over a month. So let's make this a good one, all right? Take it.
Thank you.
want to dance? Let's ask Eddie if he wants to dance. Thank you. tonight. You've been absolutely incredible. You've been kicking our ass all night. We're gonna do something off the new record. It's called A Year to the Day.
Thank you.
way to his jump. I got about an hour and 20 minutes of video. Got my YSP pass. So we're just gonna have to wait, follow him. We'll be here for a while. No limos, no vans. I don't know what's up. Got old people here. The waiting begins. Hey, Rob, yo, Rob! Let me see the back of that, man.
That's my number, so call.
Let me see the back of it.
$10 on the shirt, $10.
$10, guys, $10 on the shirt.
$5.
On the chase, we're on the fucking hunt. Twelve thirty. What'd I tell you?
One.
Is it 12:30 or one? Should I just run into him?
No.
Call. Thanks, man. All right, thanks. Later. Hold on. All right, dude, I'm gonna record this. All right. Yeah. All right, thanks a lot. Later, man. There's my mom. There's Susan.
Four people were following tradition, erecting a flagpole to fly the colors of their favorite driver. But the 30-foot pole came too close to overhead power lines, carrying 69,000 volts. The electricity arched, and John Pease of Virginia was killed instantly. Witnesses say a couple of the individuals were on fire.
Saw the one guy laying on the ground, and when they took him out, I guess it's the guy that, the bullet just went through him and blew out his shoes. I saw the one guy getting loaded up. He had white bandages wrapped all around his feet.
As I saw out of the corner of my eye, out of the trailer, it was bright flash, and I knew it was a lot of electricity.
People from other campers hurried over with fire extinguishers and put out the flames. Three of the survivors are at Crozier Chester Burn Center. A fourth is at St. Agnes in Philadelphia. Well, the electrocution has certainly put a damper on the start of the race weekend at Dover Downs. But as usual, the influx of about 100,000 racing fans will still be a bonanza for the Dover, Delaware area. Action News reporter Matt O'Donnell is live at Dover Downs. Matt, what's the situation there tonight?
Well, Jim, racegoers are slowly making their way out of here. The day's events are over, but we still, of course, have the big competitions starting tomorrow. This whole thing is about racing, about family, and fun. It was the qualifying round at the Dover Downs Speedway today. The noise of those cars was deafening, and they don't care.
So give us the whole flavor and everything.
Speed, exciting. It's a beautiful thing. There's nothing better than it.
Plenty of things to buy. Whoever your favorite racer is, this woman has no doubts.
What'd you get here?
Gordon.
Gordon what? Like a shirt and a...
Gordon shirt, Chrome Illusion, Gordon bandana.
You can't get enough Gordon.
Can't get enough Gordon. Gordon can't get enough wins.
And then there's what's going on outside of the race. There's the slots.
Come down Friday, leave Sunday night, watch a race, play a little casino stuff, and, just have a good time.
There's the cooling off period.
The basic shower right here. It ain't hot yet.
There's mealtime, but realize hamburgers are just a prelude of what's to come for this group.
Filet mignon, fresh tenderloin steaks here, which is really, really good. And I'll tell you what, I recommend everybody try the tenderloin steak.
The lots are filled with campers and those who are making a three-day vacation out of the weekend's events. Horseshoes is a pastime of choice in between races, along with a little baseball catch. But really, everyone's mind was on their favorite NASCAR driver.
And Jarrett is another one because he can maybe get Earnhardt out in the wall.
And can you drive as fast as these guys?
No. I can't even drive a car.
Here are pictures taken 1 hour ago when the qualifying round had just ended. Cars slowly seeping out of the parking lots onto Route 13. Traffic standstill in Delaware's capital city. And as we take a look back live, it is not completely over. Jim, it was a sunny day. It was a hot day. Everyone, just about everyone, is sunburned, but they're ready for more action starting tomorrow. I'm Matt O'Donnell live in the action cam in Dover, Delaware.
And of course, Matt, one of the big stories here, the economy, these 100,000 people are going to deposit about $20 million throughout the Dover area. So a big economic weekend for that area as well.
You bet.
Thank you, Matt. Well, we are now...
That's a good way to start your weekend.
In a camper park just outside Dover Downs racetrack. This is where a 32-year-old man from Virginia was electrocuted last night. Five racing fans were hoisting a flagpole attached to their trailer so they could fly the colors of their favorite driver. Of course, the big NASCAR race is Sunday. Thousands of fans setting up shop. But the wind blew the flagpole, the metal pole, too close to overhead power lines, carrying 69,000 volts. John Pease was killed instantly and actually caught fire. Two other people are in critical condition. Two others are stable. He was truly an American.
Ah, bummer, man. They didn't interview Timmy.
Described a mile from Sunday's Platinum 400, getting the pole was Rusty Wallace, 156 miles an hour. Jeff Gordon had the pole for a while, but then Rusty grabs it here and tears up the track. Finally, Veterans Stadium. Hot dog's just a dollar, so it's a hot dog eating contest. On the left,
over the warning labels on what else?
The Fluffmaster.
Well, Tim, I got three words for you. Video. I hope you saw it coming, and I hope you videotaped it. Right now, today's date. Is that date? May 30th or something. We're at front Uncle Dave's house, so I'll show you Uncle Dave's house as of 1980, 1998. the jungle, I thought. I'm gonna go back there. It's all totally overgrown. So yesterday I gotta fix the window. That's what I want. Check these chairs out. This table. Those chairs over there. China cabinet. Got a game of dominoes up there, still in the box. These are hand painted in Japan. Look, there's my mommy. There's my Uncle Tommy. Bierschmeister. Made in Singapore. And he's got this lead model up here. Pretty cool, lead. So this is kitchen. This thing's really cool. The old like farmhouse. I think this thing like slides out, slides in. The little hinges on it. That's cool. It's original. Got a can of Frosted Flakes here from 1984. This is back here. I can't get out. It's locked. I can't find the key. Probably can't even see out there. Here's just tools. Gotta take a dump. It's a nice hat. Some more tools. This is bathtub. It does have iron feet on it. These beveled mirrors. That's really neat. See what kind of goodies he has in here. God damn. Got some vodka in there. See these pins? I heard these pins that they have a one on them. They're pretty neat. I don't know who that is. He probably just painted that. As creative as Uncle Dave is. I like that corner cabinet over there. I like that. Man, this thing. It says manufactured, made in France, 36306. I gotta take it. Leva. These chairs are cause see there's like two queen and a king. Then there's these little chairs, 1, 2, 3, 4, I think there's 6. See, this really isn't a corner cabinet. Well, I gotta go, I'll be back. Yeah. I don't know what's in here. Books. Bunch of goodies. But I like to get that table set. That thing's really cool. I like this hat. Things of May. Cat and Steve. That's wood or plastic. Roger, the last straw.
When you're dealing with something that's tricky or complicated, it usually comes with instructions to help you figure it out. When you're setting up a computer, you get a user's guide. If it's your car, an owner's manual. But when it comes to analyzing the mutual funds in your portfolio, nobody's given you simple, easy-to-use instructions. Until now. Charles Schwab's mutual fund report cards are single-page reports on over 7,300 funds. From Fidelity, Merrill Lynch, Vanguard, and more. You'll find out such things as the fund's Morningstar rating, historical return, and performance within its category. All to help simplify your investment decision-making. For three free report cards, call Schwab at 1-800-4-NO-LOAD. That's 1-800-4-NO-LOAD. Because evaluating your mutual funds should at least be as easy as programming your VCR. Charles Schwab & Company, member SIPC, NYSE. Prospectus is available from Schwab. Read carefully before investing.
Quitters! This thing's really cool, but it's a typical chick. Somebody painted it. a really cool chest under here too. It's awesome, man. It's got the lock on it. Stop back. Cool box there. On the mirror. A little night table. Money Island Clay, 1949. Cocaine. Uncle Dave's a junkie. Pull mirror over here. It's all beat up there. Metal beds. Steel beds. That's cool with the painted, see? TV. Worth $1 million. That other chair. There's a bench here. Looks like you might need that. And there's another chair there that goes with that set. Holy Grail. Blue Ridge hand porcelain. That's it for Uncle Dave's house. I love it. What do you mean no care?
What?
Still the same day. Brett soda machines in front of his house. Sure you get a little glare here. And look, there's Brett himself.
Yeah, how you doing?
He don't have any shit on his face. He's growing some. He's got a Powerade, a Fruitopia, a Coke, and a Surge. He's gonna have a little stand there. A couple tables out here. Hey, 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 hey. This is where I'm residing as of June 6, 1998. Marie and I are living here at 215 South New Street. Just a wonderful place. The bedroom freezes when you try to sleep. The basement floods when it rains. The bedroom's freezing in the wintertime. The basement floods. People fly up and down the alley. I just have really a lot of nice things to say about this place. I can't wait till we move out of here. But what's going on? I'm doing a lot of gutters. Marie and I working on a mailing list from the Quadra angle. I'm working on a mailing list with my little walkie-talkie. Go around and get a bunch of addresses. This weekend we're going to go to the beach and see Candlebox. It is Thursday. Nothing much else is going on. Tommy bought a new truck. I got a 1993 Toyota pickup truck out back, and I'm waiting for the title. 3 months I've been waiting. I still haven't got it. So the only reason why I want to do is just show you my apartment. We're going to run out of tape here soon. My Marshall Guild. That's a Celebrity Guild. My office. It's our computer here. Wonderful computer. It's a Sony. You can see that. It's our printer. My mom bought us that for my birthday, or Marie's birthday, or Christmas. Megadeth, Metallica, Pantera, Eddie the King, who you just saw. Watching ER, my stereos, Emerson Sony CD player, cassette tape, CD player, receiver, Pioneer speakers, RCA TV. Basement. There's the killer bike. Some trains I got off Uncle Dave. Some models. Some lead models. That's our basement. Got this crap doing that. Phone. I don't even know what I'm going to do with all this stuff when I go to California. If I ever get there. It's a good looking guy there. To get my new teeth soon. I haven't got them yet. This is the world's smallest shower. Living in a trailer. The only thing I like about this place is it has a gas stove. Marie's vanity.
Thanks, Uncle Dave.
Do you know the guy named Mark Curry, Steve?
Mark Curry? From where?
I don't know.
Nope.
From where?
What happened to him?
Nothing.
Why did he ask me if I know who he is?
Well, she just wanted to know if you knew who he was.
What did he do?
Nothing. He did absolutely nothing.
Good conversation. Security cabinet. Oodles and noodles. Cool, blood on TV. It's our closet. Keep my tools in there. Some games, stuff I don't want to get wet. Winter jackets. That's my best buddy came from Jamaica with me. Rode first class.
Yep. Give me the cords. Too much blood.
How about a Richard in here?
Is there
anything I've seen one. I'll put up a central line kit.
Also, I need to be P1 in a little bit. Ricky.